Bertha, lovely Bertha, you are a lovely machine, and anyone who works with you will know just what I mean. Whoa, Bertha, lovely Bertha, sometimes I think you're a dream. When we work out what you have to do, you can always turn the goods out, always turn the goods out. We can depend upon you. Clicking in the day, flashing in the night, your computer is shining brightly. Some people say you have a mind of your own, and I think that's very likely, likely. Bertha, lovely Bertha, sometimes I think you're a dream. When we work out what you have to do, you can always turn the goods out, always turn the goods out. We can depend upon you.
This week at Spotty's Wooden Company, Bertha is making jigsaw puzzles. Ted puts the picture in one end. And Bertha cuts out the shapes. That's Roy checking the puzzles. Then Nell packs. And Flo stacks. It seems a shame to break up such a lovely picture.
But the fun of jigsaw puzzles is to put them back together again, isn't it?
What do you do with it when you've put it back together?
You break it up and begin all over again.
That seems daft to me. Hey, there's a hole in this one.
That means that there's a piece missing.
You're right. Hey, Ted!
Stop, Bertha!
There. See?
There is a piece missing. Right in the middle there. Sorry.
Now we'll never find the missing piece.
And why not?
Because we don't know what it looks like.
It was a piece missing from the tree, I remember.
Ah, but what piece? It was a very large tree.
A piece with leaves and branches on it.
Look here, if there's a piece of the puzzle missing, it must still be in Bertha. Now, come on, Bertha, where's the missing piece of puzzle?
Ooh.
I can't see it.
Ted, why don't you put another picture through? It might dislodge the missing piece and bring it out.
What a good idea, Roy. Now, the piece we're looking for comes from about there, so watch out for it. Now, come on, Bertha.
There's a piece missing from this one, too.
What?
A piece of the sky.
Where? Just there. Sorry.
First a piece of the tree is missing, and now a piece of the sky. Oh, I wonder what Bertha's up to.
Very mysterious. Very puzzling.
That's it, Flo. You've got the answer.
Oh, I am glad.
Now, how many jigsaw puzzles has Bertha made this morning, Flo?
10 to a big box. That's 40. 4 in this box, that's 44. And 2 here, that's, 46.
46? Roy, were there pieces missing from other puzzles?
I'm not sure. I didn't look at all of them.
It's your job too. I'd like to bet there's a piece missing from most of those puzzles. Now, come on, Bertha. How many pieces have you got in there?
Amazing. All odd bits making a different picture. I didn't know Bertha liked doing jigsaw puzzles.
You know what we have to do now, don't you?
What?
We have to open all those boxes and make up all those jigsaw puzzles to find out which pieces are missing. Oh, no. It'll take us ages. We can't let them be sold in the shops with a piece missing. Come along, let's get started.
It's better than packing.
It's better than stacking.
Bertha, how could you?
Upstairs in the offices, Miss McClackerty and Mr. Willmake are getting ready for the decorators. They're covering all the furniture with a sheet so it won't get splashed with paint.
Well done. That's everything covered. Where have those decorators got to? They should be here by now.
That's the telephone ringing, sir.
Yes, I can hear it, Miss McClackerty. Where is your telephone? Still on your desk?
No, it's on the floor somewhere.
But where on the floor, Miss McClackerty?
I can't remember, sir.
We must find the telephone and answer it. The call may be important.
Oh, dear, I'm sorry. It's under the sheet somewhere.
Right. Don't panic, Miss McClackerty. This is what we'll do. I'll go under this end of the sheet. You go under that end. Whoever finds the telephone first answers it. Off you go. I've got it, Miss McClackerty. Hello? Yes. Yes, this is the manager. Oh, I see. Well, that's too bad. Well, thank you for letting me know. Goodbye. Where are you, Miss McClackerty?
Over here, sir. Who was it, sir?
The decorators.
What did they want, Mr. Willmake?
They rang to say they're not coming today.
Oh, dear.
Would anyone here like a nice cup of tea?
Yes, please, Mrs. Tupp.
But downstairs, everyone is too busy to stop for tea.
I think most of this puzzle must be missing.
No, I'm sure there's only one piece missing from each picture.
You're just not very good at doing jigsaw puzzles, Flo. Look, I've nearly finished mine.
Have you found the missing piece, Nell?
How could I, if it's not there?
Mr. Duncan, the foreman, thinks they're just playing.
Well, Will, what's all this? Playtime?
Hello, Mr. Duncan. We're looking for missing pieces of jigsaw puzzles. We have to check all those boxes.
And those there. And those there as well.
It's going to take us ages.
Why are there pieces missing from the puzzles,
Well, Bertha's been keeping one piece back from each box and making a picture of her own.
See. Bertha has been misbehaving again, has she? Been misbehaving, haven't you?
I think she just likes doing jigsaw puzzles, that's all.
This is no good. It'll take you all week. If Bertha is so fond of puzzles, why don't you let her do them?
That's a jolly good idea, Mr. Duncan.
Now, why didn't I think of that?
That's what foremen are for.
In another office, Mr. Sprott and his assistant, Tracy, have been asked by the manager to design a machine that can paint the factory in double quick time.
Will it work, Mr. Sprott?
Undoubtedly. I will take it down to the roller and grinder machine and have it made.
Do you mind if I have a go at designing a different machine, Mr. Sprott?
No, of course not. But this is the one that'll work.
What can we have that will do the job nicely? Easy to control and will do what we say precisely. Torque operated machine is what we need here. Something I can think of that will run for a year. A torque operated machine is what we need here. Machine is what I'll do then. A super little robot that can feel like a friend. A talk operated machine, I'll call it Tom then. T-O-M, yeah, T-O-M. Then I can go and work with Bertha, set a program through, and I am sure that she can work out what I'm trying to do. I'll have to work it out as quickly as I can to get it done. I'm
know that when I get it finished, it can really be fun. Talk-operated machine is what I'll make then. A super little robot that can be like a friend. Talk-operated machine, I'll call it Tom then. T-O-M, oh, it's gonna be lovely. T-O-M, I can't wait to get it finished. T-O-M, all I have to do is put a little bit in. I've got to give him some eyes. Oh, he's gonna have a lovely little face. And if I just add a bit in, oh, this is gonna be wonderful.
This is the last puzzle, Roy.
All right, Ted, we're ready.
Is it all there, Roy?
It's all there, Ted.
Do you want to do the last one, Flo?
Oh, yes, please.
Right. Put that into the box now and we're finished. Well done, Bertha.
Hello, Ted.
Hello, Tracy. What can I do for you?
Do you think you could get Bertha to make this?
Wow, it's a robot.
What do you want a robot for, Tracy?
Mr. Sprott has designed a painting machine, but I thought if we had a robot, it could do all sorts of useful jobs around the factory. Could it help me pack? Could it help me stack? Yes. It could even help you sweep up, Roy.
Good. I could do with some help.
Very well. Let's see what Bertha makes of this.
Mr. Sprott's machine seems to be working well.
A splendid invention, Mr. Sprott. We could paint the whole factory in double quick time.
That's what I thought, sir. Stop the machine when it gets to the door, Panted, would you? There's a good fellow.
I am unhappy to say that I cannot do so, sir.
Oh, dear. Something has gone wrong. You will have to have a green door, Miss McLackenay.
But I don't want a green door.
I will quickly open the door, sir. Then the machine will have nothing to paint. Oh, dear.
Turn off the machine, Panted. Turn it off.
I'm unhappy to say that I cannot do so, sir.
Push the lever down hard.
This I have been trying to do. I will now push the lever up.
No, don't do that.
Does it work, Mr. Sprott? Oh!
Downstairs, Bertha has just finished making Tracy's robot.
Ah, there you are, Tracy. You're just in time. Is this what you wanted?
Exactly how I designed it, Ted.
What will you call it, Tracy?
Well, as you will be able to tell it what to do, I'll call it Tom. T-O-M. Talk-operated machine. Off you go, Tom.
Wow!
Well done, Tracy. Now, do you think Tom could do a spot of painting?
I think so, Mr. Willmake. Tom, will you please paint the walls in Miss McClackerty's office?
What a useful little chap. Good old Bertha. She's done it again.
Oh, Bertha, lovely Bertha. Sometimes I think you're a dream. When we work out what you have to do, you can always turn the goods out, always turn the goods out. We can depend upon you.